Ah, nighttime. Should probably make it daytime, actually, just in a moment. Maybe. Oh, dang. Well, I gotta do fast travel.
Hey,
look at that. Save myself a trip.
The forest outpost. Once you get up there, take a look in the cabin. There should be a backpack with some supplies in it. When you find it, just grab the whole pack. I had a chat with the hunters who chopped the logs you found. Turns out that the cabin had been out of firewood, so they'd gone looking for a fallen tree to carve up. You are now in the same forest they were when they found our beetle-infested tree.
I'm gonna make it daytime. I ain't gonna be chilling at this night. We'll go for 5 a.m. Where's the backpack you want me to grab? You even want me to grab a backpack? Yep, you do. Where's it at? Where is this backpack? Yeah, I'm just really blind, or it's not here. In the storage. It's not my character. Do I actually have to put a backpack on or something? No. That wasn't it? Okay. Where is the frickin' back? What the? Oh. That's not a backpack, that's a knapsack. That's like a fanny pack. What kind of a... I'm not gonna question it.
That's the one. Once you're done at the outpost, take a look in the surrounding forest. Can you find any fallen trees in that area? Spruce bark beetles are a massive threat to Alaska's spruce forest at the moment. We haven't been hit as badly compared to some other Alaskan state parks. But I think that it may be time for a quarantine. Okay. So once you find a fallen tree, I want you to take a look at its bark. Does it look healthy? If so, it's probably not the tree we're looking for.
So I'm looking for another tree.
Great job. I hope we don't need to cut these trees down, but it's the small price to pay to contain the beetles. There we go. Another tree marked. This reminds me of my summer breaks when I was a kid, helping out my dad at work. He was a tree surgeon down in Washington State.
They mentioned Washington State. That's awesome. Happy.
I used to resent him for making me go out there and work while my friends played back home. Eventually, those trips also included hunting lessons. And that that made them my favorite parts of the summer. That should do. I'll get in touch with the foresters. They can investigate the area and cut down what they need to. I'll make sure that they also pick up the firewood at Logger's Point. Don't want to take any chances. Thanks for taking care of this. It's becoming a full-on phobia of mine that these beetles are going to destroy the forest here. We sprayed pesticides across the western edge of the forest as a preventative measure earlier this month. But any new chemicals in the air, soil, or water make me uneasy. You're going to be grabbing some samples out there, so one of our research teams can test the pesticides and make sure they aren't having any effect on the ecology. This was actually my wife Sandy's idea. She runs the Yukon Valley Nature Center, so she's working closely with a visiting research team. In the same bag that you found the paint, there should be some plastic sample containers. Could you bring them out to the wetlands? Muskeg is the word we use up here in Alaska. Welcome to Yukon Valley's wetlands. The last time I brought both of my daughters here to spot birds, they told me that all the bird spotting in the world wasn't worth the smell. Turned out that a bear had left a rotting moose carcass in the summer sun. I decided to spot birds somewhere else, just in case back for a second. Watch your footing at the water's edge. It can be easy to slip and fall in. Just fill one of the containers you have with water. The pesticides we're using on the forest to prevent beetle infestation are effective, but I still have my doubts about the effects on other wildlife. The flats are one of our most biodiverse regions, so I can't risk introducing anything dangerous into the water or the food chain. Can you take some samples from the water beside the forest first? We sprayed a section of the forest's western edge last month, so I want to know if anything has changed since then.
Well, I hit him. That one dropped. It's the best part about the caribou, they're like giant white beacons. three tripods with me. Shit. Oh yeah, I finally got my second viewer. Hello, person. Damn it. That's a horrible score. Wolves are howling in the distance. Okay, so I did down that one, so I just killed three caribou.
Nicely done. First time I was there, I misjudged how stable the edge of a pond was and ended up with one leg knee-deep in the water. I was a rookie at the time, and luckily nobody saw it happen. Can you grab a second sample from a body of water slightly further away from the forest?
Thank you, Wolf. Yeah, it charged me. Okay. That was about to be bad. Place this one. That way I can taxidermy you later. Yeah, they've made it in this. This is the new map to the Hunter. It's the Yukon, so it's Alaska. So, there's like three animals that charge you here. There's wolves, a grizzly bear, and the bison. They'll charge you. The wolves try to they'll stalk you and get behind you and try to attack you in the pack. It's actually kind of cool. Oh, you left. Hurtful.
Do for water samples. Next up, I need you to find me some animal droppings in this region. The musk keg is a hotbed of animal activity, so you should find droppings quite easily. If the pesticides have drifted out to the flats, I want to know if it's making it into the food chain. It's been a month since we sprayed, so there's been plenty of time for the pesticides to get out here. That's what we're looking for. Perfect. Could you find a sample from a different species as well? It's better to grab a large size while you're already there in the field. That should do it. Now we'll be able to tell if anything larger than a fly is ingesting chemicals that we should be worried about. It's hard work wading through the mud cake, huh? I have a spot where you can drop the samples off, and I can easily pick them up. Oh, I just remembered. I've been speaking with my wife about the work you've been doing, and she mentioned a few tasks that she has on her plate that I think you could help her with. I gave her your number, so expect to hear from her. She's working on some very important studies at the moment. Hang on a second. I'm getting a call. Okay, I'm back. Slight change of plans. Before you drop off the samples, I need you to grab a hatchet from the outpost at the western edge of the flats. We have a bit of a situation out in the northwest corner of the reserve, and you're perfectly placed to take care of it. It looks like storms have weakened the roots of a tree, which is about to collapse onto the train tracks. Let me know when you grab the hatchet.
Jesus. Oh, it didn't punch deep enough. That was the issue.
Got the hatchet? Great. I hope our visitors haven't been using it to open their beams. You're gonna need a nice sharp edge. It's small, but it should do the job. There's a lake just to the north of the flats. I'll be flying over it on my way home. If you drop that stuff off there, I can jump out, grab it, and get it to one of our ecological research teams today. Instead of you having to walk around with a bag full of droppings and swamp water. The sample's ready for pickup? Fantastic. I'll be over that way as soon as I can. I really appreciate the assistance. Hunting for droppings and wading into swamp water might not be glamorous or exciting, but it's part of a massive effort to maintain the balance of life out here. It makes a big difference. You ready to head out to the tracks? Just knowing that tree is hanging over the train track is making me anxious. It's a little bit of a hike, but it's worth it to see the rail bridge. Let me know once you've found the tree. With any luck, it won't take you long to clear it out of the way. Getting close to the tree that's threatening to fall onto the tracks. I'm guessing it was loosened in a recent storm. Yukon Valley tends to get a few lightning storms each summer, but we do a thorough job of preparing. So we only saw a couple of small fires that went out on their own. Some of my team are still recording the after effects of the storms. I've heard reports of huge trees with deep roots that are now at precarious angles. It might need to be cut down. We're lucky to have such isolated incidents. Other reserves have reported landslides. I've only ever seen one landslide in person, and that was from the air. Even from up there, it was a shocking display of natural force. It was all I could do to land the plane before the storm overtook me. Hard to tell what caused this tree to tip over. I guess the big question is how to do this properly. But I trust you to get the job done. I hope you can make do with a hatchet. Great work out there. The train is taking off. I honestly don't think a single tree would do more than dent it in a collision. But I'd rather not take the chance and risk a serious accident. Speaking of the train, it's due to pass by at any moment. I'd stay clear of the tracks if I were you. Keeping that railroad open is a big responsibility for us. Not only is it essential for a lot of trade out here, but the bridge brings tourists in from all over the place. I'd like a good picture of the bridge. One that we can put on our website. See if you can snap it while the train is passing over it. That'll look great. I used to come out to this corner of the reserve with my family. We'd spend long weekends camping. And I teach my youngest daughter, Kara, how to shoot. My older daughter, Deanna, was still an angry teenager who needed convincing to take part in any activity. She'd always be laughing and having fun by the end of the trip, though. Those trips are some of my favorite memories. It brought us all closer as a family. Being alone together. That looks like a good spot to take the photo. Here's me talking about my family vacations when I can't even remember the last time I had dinner with my wife. Her birthday was what? A month ago? I think I'm probably overdue to take her out somewhere nice. It's a shame we couldn't catch it with the train on top, but it's still good. I'll send this picture over to Sandy. Her team takes care of the Yukon Valley website. Next up, head over to an outpost that we're replacing. Not too far from where you are just now. The cabin was lost in the Thcw forest fire 2 years ago. And we're in the process of replacing it with a temporary trailer, equipped with some more modern facilities. Due to the level of damage that was sustained by this area of the reserve, it has attracted several researchers who would like to perform long-term studies in the region. The Thcw forest will host our first research outpost trial. Oh, and in case you're unaware, Thcw is a native word for wolf. The fire destroyed part of the forest, but the wolves are still out there. I'd make sure you keep your rifle fully loaded at all times while you're in wolf country. I look forward to your call when you find the outpost.
Well, that's a little bit of history, because just yesterday when I started playing this DLC and talking to myself, but still... me and my friend were up there, and we saw a bunch of wolves, so that explains why they're all on the southwest side of the map. Because this is the all wolf country.
I saw the fires that tore through that forest. And I still struggle to accept just how quickly the landscape can transform into smoldering ash. Believe it or not, we got lucky. It could have been a lot worse. Maybe lucky isn't the right word. We lost too much. Stations look like they're ready to go. If this trial goes well, we might see more researchers setting up camp across the reserve. For now, though, let's get things powered up. The supplies will include fuel for the generator. Just stick a little fuel in the generator and fire it up. And where is it? Good. I'll let our researchers know they're welcome to visit when they're ready. Of course, you can sleep here and restock your supplies, just like any other outpost. The outpost is just the first part of our restoration efforts. The supplies should contain a couple of things that you're going to need for your next job. Planting new saplings. Take the bag of spruce saplings and the shovel, and let me mark a spot for you on your map. It's a tough road ahead for this part of the reserve. The fire burnt away a huge chunk of the forest, but with any luck, a pro